Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we talked about a set of microservices, like we created a two Next.js applications and we had this one MongoDB container and there was one Nginx container. Okay, so before going ahead and writing the mini microservice in Node.js, first we will talk about a different ways of microservice communication. So here you can see this Nginx and user API is making an HTTP call, right? So this is the basic HTTP REST call which your Nginx container is making to the user API, and same thing is happening with the store API. So it's like a HTTP protocol they are using to communicate between services. So what all different type of communication we have when it comes to a communication between microservices? Sometimes it happens synchronous communication, sometimes it happens asynchronous communication. When I say asynchronous, that means fire and forget. That means some action will be taken on your particular event or action which you have triggered. Okay, so this current communication which is happening between the Nginx and our store API, what we can call it is, we can call it a simple request and reply, because what is happening is Nginx is sending a request and we are just getting the response back from the user API and from the store API. We will get some particular HTTP status code 200, 500, 401 or 403 or whatever it is. And with the immediately we are also getting the response. Sometimes what happens is, sometimes you just send a request and you acknowledged, okay, your request has been sent, but the actual processing start after you submit a request. So what happens is, sometimes like from Nginx, you triggered one action and that action is not synchronous. That action will do something that will take time. In that particular case, you will just make a simple HTTP service call and you will just get a status code. You will get HTTP status code 200 saying that request has been submitted. And this is the pure HTTP based communication, right? We are using HTTP protocol. Nginx is making HTTP call to the user API, or maybe some user API is making call to another microservice. Let's say here we have another microservice which user API is calling, and that is giving us 200 response, like this is auth API, you can say. This can be another container. But sometimes what happens is, this is purely asynchronous based communication. I mean, in terms of APIs, it's a asynchronous call which we are making from the front end. But what is happening is, user API will wait until we get the data from the auth API, which will give us some object or some unauthorized error or something. And then user API will throw the same error back to the Nginx, right? So it's a request and reply. Although it will take some time, the HTTP REST API calls, there is a timeout at the HTTP server, okay. Till that time, the request will wait and then it will get timeout if your client is, if your server is not responding. So within that boundary, you will be able to get some status code with response, either 200, 500, 301, 401, whatever it is, and Nginx will receive the response. Sometimes what happens is your communication is like fire and forget. Where what you are saying is, okay, I have submitted the request, update request, okay. From store API, you have raised an event. So this is called an event-based communication, I will call it, not a simple request. So you will raise an event, okay. What this event is saying, okay, update the inventory. Now, this will give you 200, okay, I have received an event and I will act on this particular event and I will update and I will take care of this request. You will just get this and you will just send this response back to your client, okay. Nothing will happen. But after this, what all things will start happening is, this is fire and forget, not a simple request and reply call. You might be using some kind of a queue, like event driven mechanism, where you have some kind of a queues like SQS. Okay, you will push the message to this SQS queue or RabbitMQ, Kafka or whatever it is. Okay, you send a message. So this is asynchronous delivery of message. You will send the message. Now this SQS queue, there will be a subscriber microservice which is subscribing to this SQS queue, which will actually drain the message and it will process. It will take the action based on the event which you have raised. Okay, so you can say it's a processing service. And it will just update the data in the MySQL, let's say. Here we have our MySQL database. Now if you just see the overall picture, what is happening here is, this is request and reply communication where you will wait for the response to arrive. But this is fire and forget, where you submitted a request, you will acknowledged with 200 status code, okay, your request has been submitted. But this will do a lot of other things. We already know, you will submit this request to the queue, there will be a processing unit which will drain the message from the SQS queue, RabbitMQ, Kafka or whatever it is, and then there will be a service which will update the data in the MySQL. Okay, that business logic will take time, and then once the business logic is executed, you will actually notify the client. Okay, this can be another possibility. It can be as simple as our WebSocket server is running here. I mean, I'm just talking about one simple example. There can be n number of possible ways to allow this communication. Okay, so let's try to, yeah. So this is all about different ways of different possible ways in which microservices can talk to one another. So mostly what we do is we just call the other microservice using simple HTTP call. Okay, like user API will call the auth API, store API will call the inventory service using just a REST API calls. Here we are writing Node.js. Node.js will make an HTTP call. This will be pure request reply based call. Okay, you will raise an event. You are making an HTTP request. So there is obviously a timeout until which you will receive a status code and message or content. You will send this back to Nginx. Okay. So this is about microservice communications. Thanks everyone. In the next video, we will talk about building a simple Node.js microservice.